Guys, welcome back to GP Reactions. I hope you're well, hope you're having a great day. And as always, thank you for everybody that's subscribed. I've said it before, I haven't been very well for the last 4 or 5 weeks. Started out with a cold, which I thought was past, and then developed into this kind of weird cracked throat feeling where a slightest bit of change of environment, I was starting coughing all the time, I was getting a tickle in my throat. It's fine, it's not the big C, so I've had plenty of tests for that. I think it's just a really, really bad cold. I'm still kind of struggling with it now. It still feels a bit tight, as if I'm kind of like getting ready to cough all the time. So I'll just take it easy anyway. So if you're watching this, then I've tried to react to the official video of this track, but this was my second go-to choice. So I would have just seen the video, and I'll kind of talk about the video in terms of a song as I go through it. But this is a vinyl version. The group is Abba. I know this song very well. It was from the album, as it was called, which was released on the 12th of December 1977. This particular track, The Name of the Game, was released on the 14th of October 1977, and it hit the top spot. It hit number one, and it stayed there for, I'm not sure how many weeks it was there for, but it was one of those tracks that kind of felt like it endured right away for the winter. The video itself was directed by Lasse Hallström, and I think he directed most of their videos. A little note on the videos was that back in 1977, we didn't really have like the advances of technology to kind of make all these like fantastic digital videos and stuff like that. So it was down to the ingenuity and imagination and creativity of the camera work and the direction of a video to give it some depth and meaning. And having just watched it, I kind of felt that it kind of shed a new sort of light on the song for me, because I hadn't seen that video for, well, since the 70s, essentially, since it came out, although I have heard the song quite a few times. I'm looking forward to hearing it. I could probably hear Abba songs on the loop. There are a few Abba songs that I'm less familiar with, but for sure, for definite, I've seen it. So if you want to watch a kind of fresh reaction, a brand new reaction, then check out some of the younger millennial reactors who maybe have never heard Abba, because there's some really fantastic Abba reactions out there. JB Lethal is TV, he's one of the guys. I loved his like Abba reactions, but for sure, this is, just my take on a song that I hold dear to my heart. Without further ado, I'm going to click play and see what it sounds like in vinyl, because I'm not sure. I do have some vinyl Abba going back to the 70s, but I'm not sure if this is one of them. I'm pretty sure my mom had this song there.
What's the name of the game?
sorry to pause there. I mean, this is incredible, really. I was trying to keep up with the pace of the transitions in this. We had like this dreamy first verse where she's kind of just like telling us what it is, what her life is. I've seen you twice in a short time, only a week since we started. It seems to me for every time I'm getting more open-hearted. And then there's the transitions into the next verse, which is a little more direct and personal. And, you know, I was an impossible case. No one ever could reach me. But I think I can see your in your face. There's a lot you can teach me, sir. You know, we really get a sense that she's now connecting with the person that she's with. But we don't really know kind of why and in what way. And then we go into the chorus, which is a little bit more pleading. So I think she's got enough trust in this person that she's with for her to actually ask for questions in a relationship that take you or may take you to the next stage. What's the name of the game? Does it mean anything to you? What's the name of the game? Can you feel it the way I do? Tell me, please, because I have to know. I'm a bashful child. Does that mean bashful? Does that mean shy? A little bit withdrawn? I'm a bashful child beginning to grow. So she's kind of laying it on the line there. She's making that move to say, you know, do you feel actually the way I feel about you? And she's kind of making a case for herself, it seems. And then we go into like a more kind of persuasive tone. I think this may be where Frida's singing. And you make me talk and you make me feel and you make me show what I'm trying to conceal. If I trusted in you, would you let me down? Would you laugh at me if I said I care for you? Could you feel the same way I do? I want to know. I mean, this is just the amount of transitions in songs like these, especially with Abba, is what kind of hooks you in, because the moment you get to like 1, 2, 3, 4, fifth transition, you kind of forget what the first couple of transitions were like. So you're going to want to listen to the song over and over again. I mean, I'm not a musical expert, but we all know when we hear certain songs that you think, by the time you get to the end of a song, you know what, I've enjoyed that so much, but I can't remember why. And you need to go back and listen to it again. Music's really, really sort of intricate as well. Again, not a musician, so I can't really delve into that too much. Maybe go try and listen to the music a little bit to see if there's anything interesting going. There's like a weird kind of horn section, but I thought it was a horn, but it wasn't. I think it's like a synth going on or keyboards or something. Yeah, I'm learning so much from this record, having never really stopped to properly listen to it.
Show what I'm trying to conceal if I try.
Wow, that was Abba with The Name of the Game, and I really, really love this final. I really love this final version. I might just stick with this final version, actually. I mean, obviously, I haven't tried to upload the other one yet, but the video, I was a little bit more absorbed in what they were doing, and but with this, I'm really kind of getting more out of this vinyl version. So she goes on to say, I have no friends, no one to see, I'm never invited, now I am here talking to you, no wonder I get excited. So you kind of feel like this, she's just raised the stakes. She's not only telling him that she's, you know, she wants to be able to open up more because she's beginning to trust him, and the way he is with her makes her feel very comfortable about being open. But she's now saying, well, I've got nobody else, so you're kind of it. So, and that can have a detrimental pressure on a partner if just one of you is, he might be like a really sociable person, but if she's saying that she's got no friends, and not only are you her lover, confidant, but you're also gonna have to be her one and only friend as well. And I kind of felt like that put a bit of pressure on it, but I mean, simply she's just trying to explain, I guess. Your smile and sound of your voice and the way you see through me, got a feeling you give me no choice, but it means a lot to me, so I want to know. You know, and it kind of feels like you've got all these different elements of hope. You're putting your faith in someone, you're hoping that they will be reciprocal in their love for you, and also, you know, you're kind of trusting all of this. So it's crazy, and the chorus is just fantastic. You know, what's the name of the game? Your smile and sound of your voice, does it mean anything to you? Got a feeling you give me no choice, but it means a lot. What's the name of the game? It feels euphoric, but it also feels quite earnest, and it feels like she's really making a case for herself, but she's trying to kind of make it sound that she's putting her heart and soul in laying her heart and soul out on the table. It's very emotional. And then we kind of like bring it back down when she says, and you make me talk, you make me feel, and you make me show what I'm trying to conceal. So she's trying to give a statement of fact to him about, rather than just be on which one level of emotional pleading, she's actually trying to be calm about it, saying, these are reasons why I really want to be with you, and I want to open up to you because he's saying you make me feel. But she wants him to kind of like open up and meet her halfway. There's a real fine line. It feels like the witching hour in a relationship when you take that next step. And I guess it takes, I think some relationships are more organic. They just tend to kind of grow to this thing where you both say, you know, one day that you both say to each other, you know, we love each other, I love you, you love me. But then some relationships take a little bit of, you have to kind of like take a little stick to them and crack open that pinata. But yeah, the musicness was great. The harmonizations was beautiful. I think both Agnetha and Annie Frid, do you know what, forgive me if I pronounce their names wrong, because I'm not Swedish and I find it difficult to say their names sometimes. But yeah, when they combine their vocals, it's fantastic. But then they're very different kinds of vocalists themselves, I get the impression, and you know, they have different ranges to their voices, which just adds an extra element to these songs. And yeah, it's a really, really nice song. And also, this song just reminds me of snow. I can't remember whether I said that at the beginning. It just reminds me of the cold weather of winter, because even though it came out in October, I think 1977 felt extremely cold. And so it kind of felt kind of warm and cozy. Now, the video, contrary to this, is I think it was filmed in summer. But the thing I loved about the video, not only was the creative camera angles and the way it was filmed, which was superb, especially when they're sort of spinning around. The other thing I loved about the video was that at moments it felt distant, so you could be watching them just playing a game from another table. And then there's other moments which feel very intimate and direct. And I kind of like if the parts of a song, parts of a video didn't really, there wasn't any kind of lip syncing going on with each of the singers. When they were direct, you kind of knew that it was a dialogue happening between them. And it's just, the video was wonderful. This final version is amazing. It kind of helps me imagine the song even more. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this. I really, really loved listening to this song thinking about, you know, how it kind of made me feel and the lyrics to it as well. Just make a big difference. I'll do just that one thing. I just wanted to kind of clear it up that this is maybe an organ or some kind of keyboard and not a horn section. So, okay, it just kind of starts now. And when I've heard this in the past, I always thought it was like maybe a brass instrument of some kind, but very high scale. But I'm now thinking it might be a keyboard instrument or synth or whatever they were using. Yeah, I mean, that sounded like a keyboard. Anyway, that's really kind of all I wanted to say about this song. And please join me in the comments below. As I said, I'd love to hear what your thoughts are on these, on ABBA and the name of the game. And if you have any memories from that winter of 1977, you know, what he was up to, what he was doing. I'm not gathering data. I just really want to hear your memories. And you know, it's just a beautiful piece of nostalgia. I know ABBA's got some new music out now. But for me, this was, you know, part of the fabric of my life, and you will never be able to kind of extract that from me. So I can hear new ABBA stuff now. It doesn't really have the same connection for me. But yeah, I mean, I love it, watching some of the younger folk react to ABBA songs, because it does something to your soul when you hear these songs. It's the intricateness, the heart and soul of the voices. You know, it has an effect on the ears of anyone that's never heard these songs before. So, do you know what? Till next time, take care of yourselves. Have a beautiful day and a fantastic week. And I'll catch you all soon.